Invisi-Tag. I'm the general manager here, also the sales manager. You may have heard of Invisi-Tag. It's been out for quite a while now. We are designed around the restoration industry, although we also service landscape, medical, education, rental, all those industries as well. Invisi-Tag is an equipment tracking and inventory solution that allows you to keep track of your inventory, take very fast inventory, and allows you to track your equipment from warehouse to truck to job and back. We do integrate with PSA, and in integration, you're allowed to, the Invisi-Tag app will sync your job location information, your warehouse information, and vehicle information into the app so that you can then move your equipment throughout the app and see it in real time on our enterprise website. We've successfully combined RFID technology, a quick and easy app, and a very powerful enterprise system that allows you to track this equipment from warehouse to truck to job and back. So what I'd like to do is present our app and show you how this app works and how that relates to the restoration industry. With Invisi-Tag, the first thing you would do is tag your equipment. And we use RFID tags for every piece of equipment. We have different types of tags for different equipment. We also allow you to customize your tag with your company logo, phone number, website, all that information, so that if equipment is lost or stolen, it can be returned to you quite easily. So without further ado, I'll kind of get right into the app. I'll share my screen on the app and show you what that might look like on a day-to-day basis for a regular restoration company. Let me pop this screen up here. So when you open the Invisi-Tag app, you'll notice that all of the screens are designed with large buttons so that it can be easily navigated in the field. In most instances, you know, you're going to want someone to pull their app out, be able to take inventory or move equipment rather quickly. And to do that, we use a Bluetooth connected RFID reader, which connects to the app. And so when you click begin, you would choose jobs. Within the app, you can create different locations, warehouses, trucks, and jobs. You can take inventory of these locations really fast using RFID, or mostly fast using our QR codes. And you can also move equipment between these locations in seconds. So what I'll show you first is how to move equipment from one location to another. You would click move equipment, choose the location which you're moving equipment to. So if you have equipment in a warehouse and you want to load a truck with equipment, you would choose truck, pick the location. At this point, you would connect your RFID reader. Now, if you decide that you need to move equipment without the RFID reader, that can be done using the QR codes on the equipment as well, which I'll show you in the next movement. So the reader does connect rather quickly. From here, I would scan my equipment. And in this case, I have about 14 tags laid out in the office here. Pull the trigger. So it quickly picks up every one of these tags using RFID. So it sends a signal out to the tag. The tag sends a signal back to the system, says, these are the 14 tags that I have detected. You would complete your transfer. And it gives you a quick summary screen. You've moved 14 pieces of equipment to truck one. And from here, you can put the app in your pocket and get on with your day. Moving forward, when you get out into the field, you might want to move equipment into a job. Now, like I said, with PSA, if you create a job in the PSA system, it will land it in Invisi-Tag if you sync it up into the app. So that would look like this. You would click move equipment, choose your job from the drop-down menu, which I've already created a job in here. Pick the job. And like I said, out in the field, you might not want to have RFID readers in every truck. That could be cost prohibitive at some point. So you could use the QR code. And by pushing the little button of a QR code, you just scan the tags in sequence. And in this case, I've added three pieces of equipment to this job, which I've named after myself. It gives you a quick summary of the equipment that you detected, complete the transfer. And this is where all of the functions come into play that are most important to our restoration customer. Once you click OK, the first thing it's going to ask you is, do you want to create a GPS pinpoint for this location? If you say yes, it uses Google Maps, draws you to the location. You can dial that in. And it should auto-populate for you. And now I've created a GPS pinpoint for that location, which is being stored in your Invisi-Tag Enterprise account. You can also have somebody sign for equipment. Type in the name, have them sign, hit confirm. It's now saving that signature to this job. You can also create a due date reminder by clicking the due date reminder toggle. The default is set for 2 days, but you can easily change that. Let's say a week from now, click done. So now we have a job that has been created. We created a GPS pinpoint for this job. We had somebody sign for the equipment on this job. And we set an alert for the system to tell us in 6 days that this equipment is at this job and you need to pick it up. If you notice on the screen, it gives you the type of equipment. It has a start time and end time. When you move equipment into a job, it then starts to track the amount of time that each piece of equipment is in this job and allows you, it gives you a bill hours over a certain amount of time. So you can bill against the amount of time that the equipment is in the job. When you associate tags in your system, you can also create a rental cost for each piece of equipment, and it will begin to start to calculate the rental cost for that equipment that's out in a job as well. So in this case, we've created the job, we've got it all set up, we can sync it to the cloud, and now this information will be available to see in your enterprise website from any browser. Once it's synced, they can put it in their pocket, get on with their day, and keep working. When somebody comes to pick this equipment up from a site, the process is again very, very much the same, very easy to use at the app level. Move equipment, choose the location you're moving it to. We're gonna put it back into a truck. We'll choose truck 2. Again, they can use their barcode at this point. It picked up the 3 items, complete the transfer. And now it's pulled those pieces of equipment out of that job and put them back into truck 2. Moving equipment into the warehouse is the same process and even easier with our RFID reader. You would move equipment. We're gonna move it right back into the warehouse it came from. Pull the trigger, picks up all 14 items in a matter of milliseconds. You complete that transfer and it's been moved back into the warehouse. So as you can see out in the field, this system is easy to use, it's fast. All of the equipment that you have, if it's tagged, you can take inventory of this equipment relatively quickly. If you were to have this equipment in a vehicle, a lot of cases, restoration companies have vehicles with equipment in it ready for deployment at any given time. And you need to take quick inventory of all your equipment without having to stop processes. You can literally grab your equipment inventories. If I were to put all this equipment in a truck, complete the transfer. Now this equipment is in this truck. You can take inventory just as quickly by clicking take inventory, choosing that truck, you pull the trigger. And if it picks up anything that's not supposed to be in that inventory, it will tell you it's a yellow tag. This is a piece of equipment that isn't supposed to be here and gives you a chance to review that. So as I've been doing all of this, taking inventories, creating a job, moving equipment, it takes this information and it puts it up into our enterprise warehouse, our enterprise website where you can review this at any given time. You can print reports, but that's not the only way you can get reports from our system. You can go to our reports tab and you can look at inventory reports as the inventory that I just took. And you can also send these reports, I don't have an email set up, but it would send this to an email that you set up in the system. So you can quickly send information to anybody you need to. You can also pull up job reports and you can send that information as well. It will create a CSV file and allow you to send that via email, AirDrop, however you want to move that information. Let me just get out of here really quick. Sync my information. So again, everything that I've just done has been pushed up into our enterprise website. So what I'd like to do is move from the app into the enterprise website and show what some of this reporting does look like. Just give me a moment to stop the share on the screen. So when you open your enterprise website, it's going to bring you to a dashboard screen such as this. And on this dashboard screen, it's just going to give you snippets of all the information that you have in your system. So the number of tags that you have, which would be the number of equipment that you have. Number of locations, this is a combination of your warehouses, trucks, and jobs. Pieces of equipment that are checked out to a job. In this case, I'd move those three pieces of equipment into a job, but then I pull them back out, but it's still available for you to look at in the reporting. And your employee count. If you scroll down on your main page, you have in progress jobs on one side and then completed jobs below that. Let me just refresh my screen to make sure I have the most recent information. Excuse me. On the right side, you're going to have your snippets of your inventories. So you'll have incomplete inventory scans. Those are scans that didn't detect all of the equipment that was supposed to be in an inventory list. And then you're going to have your complete inventory scans, and those are scans that you did that did detect everything that was supposed to be in. One of the scans might look like this. It gives you the report summary of the equipment that was detected, what was not detected, anything that was extra in that inventory. It'll give you the total asset value of the equipment on that scan, the date and time it was scanned and who scanned it. And then it will show you each piece of equipment and whether or not it was detected. And if a piece of equipment was not detected, you can always click details on that line and get the complete history of that particular piece of equipment. So those are the past locations, also every inventory that was taken for that, that had that piece of equipment in that inventory list. Now, if you move along your location lists, again, these would sync over from PSA. If you created a job in PSA, it would come over here once you sync it. And you can view these jobs from here, and you can also view them in the reportings tab. So these are your locations, all your trucks, your warehouses, and any job that you might have, and those are indicated by the icon here. You can move equipment into any of these locations by clicking transfer here. And when you sync your app, it will move that information in the app as well, so all of the information is real time. In your tag list, this is one way you can upload tags. You would add a tag, you would give it its name, its RFID number, choose the type of equipment from the drop-down menu. You can also add types of equipment if we don't have them in there, but we generally have everything. You can give it an asset cost, a rental cost, a second rental cost, a date purchased, and you can create notes for each piece of equipment. You can also upload tags by downloading our CSV file. You can do a data entry with all that information following the tag formats and then upload them back into the system so that you can use those tags immediately once you sync your app. The reports are where everything is most, all your most important information is going to be in your reports tab. Obviously, the inventory reports, I've already kind of showed you one of those. All of your incomplete are on top and in red, so if something is missing, it's going to show up here and it will be in chronological order. And all of your complete inventory reports are here. And if you notice, on every table that I show you, there is going to be an export button, print CSV or PDF. So you can export it or you can print it in either of these two formats or you can print it out. And what an inventory report looks like, when you click on it, it has all that information, and again, you can just go ahead and print this or send it to somebody if you need to, especially when you have an incomplete report. You might want to send that to somebody in charge of that inventory. We have a location status report. This is a where's my stuff button, that's what I call it. It gives you a summary of all of your equipment, the total number of pieces you have, and how many of each type of equipment that you have. What is in, which is available to be set to into a job, what might be out to a job, and equipment that may not be scanned into an inventory at this point. And then in this table, you are able to sort this by anything you like. You can sort it by equipment type. You can sort it by location. You can search by location. If you were to put in the name of a job here, it would pull those pieces of equipment up. For example, if I start to click truck one, type truck one, I should say. It's going to show you all the equipment that's in that vehicle. And again, on every one of these tables, you can check, click details and check the history of that piece of equipment. So if something is missing from an inventory report, you can easily click back on that particular piece of equipment and see where it was most recently. And gives you an idea of who to talk to or where to go to try to find that piece of equipment. Location jobs report, these are your different in progress and closed out jobs. What a job report might look like is this. This will give you the total bill hours for the equipment on the job, the asset value if you have associated assets with the equipment, who dropped off the equipment, who picked up the equipment, the due date if one was set for that job, the address. You can look at the GPS pinpoint. You can also look at an allocation signature if you've created one. It gives you a summary of the equipment that's been on the job. It also gives you a start time and an end time for each piece of equipment that was in the job. So if some equipment is picked up prior to other equipment, you'll have different start times and end times, and the bill hours will reflect that. You can choose whether you want hours or days for your bill hours. And again, this can be exported or printed out, which is great for billing. You can export it in a CSV or PDF file, and you have all this information there. It's indisputable. These things were either scanned barcode or RFID, and you can submit this for billing. A map overview. So when you create the GPS pinpoint for a job, it's going to drop that job on a map for you, which is great if you've got multiple jobs running in any location. You can look at that location and see all the different jobs in the area. That way, if you have somebody on one side of town and you know that they can pick up a couple of dehus or air movers from another job, it's easy to kind of figure out what that route might look like. And then if you click on the job here, it would show you the equipment that is on that particular job. Past due reports. Those are anytime a job goes past that due date, it will show up in your past due reports. It will also push a message to you saying that this equipment is on this job. When you create new employees in the system, it's very simple to do. You add employee, you give them a name and an employee ID. And then when they log into the app under their name and employee ID, anytime they do an inventory or they move equipment in or out of a job, that person is stamped on that movement or that inventory. So it allows you to know what's going on and who's doing what right under your nose. You can also enable each person as a barcode user, or you can disable that function. And there's also a manual scan function, which allows you to tap the line on the app to move equipment or take inventory of it. Not something we recommend for everybody. It's sort of a backup to a backup. If you have a broken camera on your device and you don't have an RFID reader near you, that might be something that you would enable for that particular user. So again, in the enterprise, clicked the wrong thing there. Everything you need to see is right here on your main page, and then you can go further in to look at your reports, to upload tags. So everything I've done in the app is now in the enterprise website. I can also create locations within the enterprise website and sync those down to the app. So if I wanted to create a job in here, I could go ahead and add a location, name it what you like, choose whether it's a warehouse, truck, or a job, add that location to the system. And when somebody opens an app and syncs it, then they would have that information in their app ready for them to move equipment in or out of or take inventory of that particular location as well. That's a quick overview of the Invisi-Tag system. It, like I said before, it does integrate with PSA and allows you to pull information over, such as job location, warehouse, and vehicle. If you want more information on that, you can email me or you can use our contact form on our website. We can get you as much information as you need on that. So that's a quick overview of the Invisi-Tag system. I'd like to open up to questions, because generally people have questions regarding specific situations, and I'd love to answer those questions for you.
Thank you so much, Smack. And if you could enter them in the chat box, if anyone has any questions, then we can get started with those questions. We'll wait a couple of minutes.
And while we're waiting for that, I can also mention that we have introduced a solution for every budget at this moment. We used to be just RFID. We do now have RFID solution, which is our flagship. We call that level 3. We have level 2, which is using QR code only. So you would have the same enterprise and the same app, but you would only be using the camera on your device to take inventory or transfer equipment from one location to the next. It's a little bit less to get started with that. And then we have a level 1 where it is the app only. The app only will not integrate, just so you know. It's going to be app only. It does not include the enterprise website or any of the connectivity to the web. But it works for, you know, small companies that just have a few pieces of equipment or not a whole lot to keep inventory of.
Thank you, Mac. We do have a question, but it's not necessarily directed to you. It's asking about, okay, good. The question was, if she's had a bad connection, where can you find the recording to rewatch? We actually upload these to YouTube, so you should be able to, you will receive a link to that. If there are no other questions, we can go ahead and end our session. Thank you so much, Mac, for your time today. We hope you have a great day. Y'all take care. Bye-bye.